And welcome to another replay cast. And today I'm gonna show you a replay of, from two perspectives, which include a hard carry of our division. The title says, I think, enough. I don't have to spoil more. Yeah, this is one of the closest game I had recently, I would say. And yeah, of course, it's weekend, and that are the times when you have to carry a lot of games. I mean, among the week, or when during the week, there's also the gameplay isn't really great either, but on the weekend it gets significantly worse, in my opinion. So yeah, let's have a quick look on the matchmaking. Yeah, it's Mazru, Prosen, and myself. Triple division, two cruisers, one DD. We have radar, so that's always a good thing. And yeah, apart from that, tier 9, tier 10. A lot of tier 10s though, so you can imagine how hard it is to carry these games. But yeah, let's see what happens in this game. First of all, we decided to send or to go to B, especially Mazru has this Des Moines and the radar. We can use it quite effectively. Enemy has 3 radars. So capping B is a quite dangerous thing, so we send him to C because it's significantly easier to cap it than B. If you go B, I mean, you can cap it, but it's always including a big risk. Taking some pot shots on some broadside targets down there and below B. Pretty standard stuff. And of course, you want to figure out on Haven. You always want to figure out where's the enemy strong, if he's going over the C flank or over the B flank. And it looks as if the most of the ships is going over the B flank, which is the favorable side. Yeah, and that's what happens if you go close to B. The gearing wasn't even in the cap, and he got radared and deleted. He had no exchange escape plan, and that's got him killed pretty easily. You don't want to be caught in this area. You want to be behind that island or here, just on this, so you can run away immediately. I asked Mazru to pop radar so we can maybe interrupt and chunk down the DDs a bit, which comes probably in handy later on when Prosen, because Prosen has to deal with these DDs. So yeah, chunking them down one by one. But we can't take out one, if I can remember correctly. And you see how many ships are there. Conqueror, Kurfürst, Montana. And it's only a few of them. And I get shot at by the Missouri there. So there's quite a lot of stuff, so I'm forced to turn away. Mazru is pretty safe behind that island. He can just like shoot in this direction and farm them as he wants. I'm just exchanging some shells. Our force isn't bad either, but somehow our team, yeah, you will see, is doing some great stuff to fuck this a bit up. Alright, using my spotter plane to get some additional damage done. Stopping completely so that I'm not too far away from Mazru, because he needs some cover. I mean, I can't stop the whole push, and of course Mazru needs to relocate. Same, he is playing the Des Moines as a stationary cruiser in the beginning. Means he needs his team to secure the flank, so he's safe. Until the point they can't hold it, or the enemy is dead, then he has to reposition, of course. So yeah, basic stuff what I explained already in the Cleveland video some days ago. All right so issue for us here is we have no spotting. The battleships are playing not that stupid. I mean, they have secured B. It means they turned around because there's actually no need to push. But they somehow managed to get a lot of damage done on our battleships up here. The main issue I have with some players is their impatience. They can't take like getting damaged and not shooting in return, because it's absolutely not favorable. If we would have been here one or two cruisers more, I think we had an easy time, but with all the battleships against angled battleships, not going to work that good. Working on the Conqueror, since he's the biggest threat to my battleships, we can burn them down easily. And yeah, I want to prevent that. That's why I'm focusing the Conqueror here. Of course, the Zao is also an issue in the Hindenburg, but yeah. When it comes to pure raw damage, the Conqueror damages the battleships the most. I mean, 10k salvos, HE salvos are no... how can I say it? No rare cases. And the only thing the enemy Conqueror needs to do is just like spread out the fires. And that's what he is exactly doing. So I'm playing here the kiting role, but I'm not too successful. 40k damage just because we have no continuous spotting, but I can't go too close because yeah, there are too many battleships that even a Hindenburg isn't able to tank. Yeah, no luck with additional fires on the Conqueror. He activated his heal. And again, no luck. You see that Mazuru is pulling a bit back, which is a smart move. These BBs, yeah, the Yamato, they have really hard times. The Friedrich has hard times. The Conqueror would be excellent if he would have been in this area here, because he can use his concealment and also return the favor of burning down the enemy battleships, but he's not doing that, and he lost a lot of HP already, which is, yeah. Prosser, meanwhile, torped the Cleveland. That was somewhere, I don't know, where he died. Probably that one. Yeah. Our Yamato is going down, thanks to the Conqueror, and because he showed a bit too much broadside. Yeah. And that's the whole story of this flank. And look at the team score. We lost already 5 ships, while the enemy only lost 2. But the enemy Conqueror managed to beach himself, which is equal to a death sentence if he's that close to Mazuru and me. We just chunk him down bit by bit, and nothing he can do about. Even with his monstrous heal. Alright, yeah. Next target is the Missouri, because we need a third cap. Otherwise, I think we can't kill as many ships as we would like to have. Or would like to kill. And I'm already shifting a bit over to protect this area, since the enemy is assembling here. And yeah, I'm smelling that they will push or try to push here, and at that time also on the other side, which makes it even harder to hold one flank. But I trust in Mazuru and Prosan. And Prosan is going in as soon as the Missouri is down. That was the plan, and that's what you hopefully achieve. Yeah. Next one goes down. Prosser lands quite good torps on the Missouri, so it's just upon us to chunk it down. As soon as the Missouri is down, I'm switching to Mazuru's perspective, because from that part on, it gets interesting. He doesn't want to die that quickly. Alright, so he's dying. Okay, see you in a moment from Mazuru's perspective. Alright, here we go out of Mazuru's perspective. He's now going to support Prostan a bit closer in the B cap, And as I said, I'm shifting over to maybe reset or protect this A or C cap. The fact that Mazur is spotted tells him that he's probably spotted by the enemy gearing. We saw some torps coming from this way, so he's assuming that there is a DD close. And the fact that he's located tells the whole story, I guess. There is a smoke up on there, so he's giving it a try and catches the gearing off guard. Gearing is way too much in the open to close, and now he's turning in, which is even worse for him. Mazur is turning out to avoid the shells from these guys down here. And of course makes sure that this island is between him and Montana, so that Montana can't hurt him at all. And enemy gearing is down. That's frag number one for Mazuru. Prosan made sure that he has some kind of... that he is smoked in the B area. And Mazuru made sure that he can shoot down the B, but he's eating some additional damage, but he's focusing the Hindenburg. Because he might be the biggest threat, except for that buffalo for Prosan, since he might have Hydro running. And of course, he's scoring some nice citadels, which is quite helpful. The biggest issue is, though, the Montana down here. And the only one that can really, really hurt this Montana is Prosan. And I think he will do this. Yep, he is launching torps. And Montana has a big, 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 big issue. While Prosan is running out of the B cap. Yep, Montana down, Hindenburg down means Mazuru is able to go around that corner to help Prosan with the Buffalo, who I'm pretty much sure will radar him any second. Meanwhile, I'm working on the Kurfürst up here, and yeah, there's also Tirpitz and somewhere Zhao and the gearing. Now it's only the three of us. I think we started the fight against, now it's five, I think seven ships, maybe even eight, I'm not sure. I didn't pay attention. When I watched it the first time, I forgot as well. Yeah, nice and juicy broadside there from the Buffalo. And he's radaring Prosan right now, who was on his toes and is running away. Yeah. The Buffalo reacts a bit too late, and that's costing him his life. Alright, so that means B secured, A is now under pressure because the enemy gearing went in there, which makes it quite hard for me to hold it, but I'm able to burn down the enemy Kurfürst. Still a full HP Tirpitz left Zhao and the gearing. I mean, at least we equaled out the number of ships. And yeah, it was really important kill there with the Kurfürst. So it's only one battleship I have to worry about, and the Zhao, of course, has a good concealment. Let's see what he's up to. Tirpitz spotted, and the fact that Mazur got spotted tells him that either the gearing is up, so must be the Zhao. And the Zhao is making a crucial mistake. He's getting shot at, and is turning right into the volley of Mazur, who just wrecks him. And now he's working on the Tirpitz, same like me, and the gearing is spotted by Prosan, and I have guns on him as well, so pretty easy. I'm taking out the gearing, and now we, yeah, turned the game around. The only competitor we have now is the Tirpitz, and honestly, against two tier 10 cruisers and a DD, that's not going to work out. No matter how hard he will try, I think. So So, he gets... focused hard now. Meanwhile, Mazur also gets the Confederate Award. Yeah, and it's basically how you can carry games, or if you're lucky enough and have enough time and your positioning is not as bad, you can carry these games. But honestly, the team was like dead so quickly, it was just incredible. Incredible bad, I would say. But here you see me making a mistake. I'm going a bit too close and now I'm turning out. And yeah, that's what the turbo was just waiting for, and yep, that's me dead. So that was quite a sloppy play there by me, so it wasn't absolutely not necessary. And of course now they need the Tirpitz dead, because it's only 3:45, but Prosen's Torps looks good. I can remember that the enemy Tirpitz had damage con, so he's not going to survive this. And Mazu is just waiting because he has 4 kills, so he gets the Kraken. I'm writing what the game, because I can't believe it. Tirpitz still flooding, but Mazu seals the deal, gets the Kraken, and yeah, ends the game. So that's kind of the happy carries you have on the weekend. We had like 4 losses in before that game, and we thought, oh my god, that can't be in again. And yeah. Here we see the result screens. So Prosan made a nice 192k damage, killed 3 ships, Confederate, and I think 2 devastating strikes. Base resets, 12 torpids, all the shit you want to have. 3 captures, so quite a lot. He came around a lot. Then Mazru, 220k around, 5 kills, Confederate, Kraken, high caliber. 13 citadels, yeah. That's already 8 ships that only our division killed. And me, as the worst among us, with 3 kills and Confederate Award, that makes 11 kills. So we killed 11 out of the enemy 12 ships, which is rather sad, to be honest. And yeah. Let's check the result screen. And yeah, you see it. Mazru on top with 3.25 base XP, Prosan 2.6, and me even though with 2.2, even though I didn't play that well, in my opinion, especially in the end. That turnout against the Tirpitz was unnecessary. I should have just charged into him and it wouldn't matter, I think. Yeah, and that's basically it. One of these hard carries you can have on the weekends. We were, I don't know if we were lucky. I think our positioning was quite well. Every one of us did quite a good job. We supported each other as good as we could. And that's why we ended up where we ended up, I guess. And yeah, of course, the enemy made mistakes by being a bit too aggressive when they had already the game in the bag. But honestly, who can blame them? I mean, I know these games when the enemy is just vanishing. The battleships die within like minutes because they are not able to, or they don't know how to tank correctly, and they are like continuously shooting no matter how many fires they have on them, or if they are flooding or on damage con, it doesn't matter. The battleships are going down so quickly, and of course Conqueror, Zhao, Hindenburgs can capitalize on it so easily. Battleship players make most of the mistakes normally, and if your battleships die, normally the game is over. But yeah, we were able to turn it around and had a quite, yeah, good game, I would say. All right, boys and girls, thanks for watching this. If you liked it, give it a like. If you have anything to comment on, just put it in the comments. Otherwise, I wish you a nice Sunday and see you next time. Bye-bye.